and welcome to Coffee Talk with Quinn! And I'm your host, Quinn Stinklemeyer! And today, we have a super fantastic show for you! I'd like to introduce my guest for you today! You've heard his music at local festivals and concerts! He's been playing with musicians across the state! Please give a warm welcome to my guest, Chris Pepper!
Hello, Quinn. It's good to be here.
So good to see you today. So, Chris, can I call you Chris?
You may.
When did you start playing music? With what instrument?
May I first, Quinn, just start by saying... Dun, 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 dun. So, I first started playing music my senior year in high school. What kind of inspired me to play is my father played music. He played blues music all throughout my life. And for my senior graduation present, he got me an acoustic guitar. And so that's when I started. That was in 2002. So that was about 45 years ago. And since then, you know, I've gone on, you know, met people and... It's just been completely fulfilling. I've always had a passion for it and never got tired of it. Yep, I've been playing it ever since.
Wow. And is that your instrument of choice, or what's your favorite instrument to use?
Well, I play a variety of instruments, Quinn. My instrument of choice would have to be the acoustic guitar. That's what I started out with. I just started playing it a lot and all the time. I've played all sorts of things, ukulele, mandolin, a little bit of keyboard, some percussion, but my instrument of choice would have to be the acoustic guitar. I like to write songs a lot. I like to play a lot of songs. I like to play a lot of things that have kind of an acoustic feel to it. And when I put the acoustic guitar on, start rocking, I just feel completely comfortable. And everything else kind of fades away, and I'm just me in the universe or sea floating around, completely happy.
That kind of reminds me of when I start my coffee maker. I always feel so relaxed and
yes.
happy.
Yes, I want to thank you for the coffee.
Oh, you're welcome.
It's good.
Yes, yes. You know, coffee is a lot like an electric guitar. It's best when you amp it up.
Quinn.
So, talking about your band, what kind of music does your band play? When did you start?
Well, I started playing music with my band, you know, probably about 12 years ago, 13 years ago.
Oh, wow.
My band's name is called the Fabulous Pepper Shakers. The main members consist of me, Chris Pepper, and my father and I, and Robert Pepper is his name. And we started playing, we got together, I've probably known him for about since I was born. And one day, you know, once I started playing guitar, we were just like, well, why don't we start playing music? And so we started playing, we're both big fans of the Beatles, which, you know, were, you know, the start of rock in the 60s.
Oh, yeah.
For anyone who doesn't know the Beatles, I would look it up, maybe ask your parents. And so we started playing out a lot of Beatles songs. And I had some originals, and we played originals. We played some classics from the 80s, and, you know, we still do now. We're still playing. And we've had different other musicians stand in with us, either playing, you know, drums or even horns, like saxophone. Just for years and years and years. So, yes, the Pepper Shakers, and, yeah, we like to rock.
That's amazing. It must be a lot of fun to have people that you're so close to in your band.
It is a lot of fun, Quinn. One of the things I like about it is, you know, I mean, you have your relationship with your family members, and for my father and I, besides being father and son and just doing the things all our lives, spending time with together, playing music together kind of adds a different element of our connection as father and son, and something that, you know, I would do with a bunch of friends somewhere, but I have my dad, luckily, and he plays mainly lead guitar, and I play mainly rhythm. And so, if I may explain, Quinn.
Mm-hmm.
So rhythm, you know, I basically sing and do the rhythm like Havana, na na na, dun dun. That would be like the original part. Da 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 da. Then for say a solo, that would be my dad on lead guitar. And lead guitarist, you know, has to do what the front man and rhythm guitarist says. So.
Wow, well, that's really cool. So. Who are some of your favorite musicians? Like, are you inspired or influenced by other people?
I am very inspired by several musicians. I like all sorts of music. For me, mainly, again, it would have to be the Beatles, John, Paul, George, and Ringo. I started listening to them when I first started playing guitar and really kind of started, you know, listening to the lyrics and the rhythms. And from the start, it was very catchy. They were very compassionate about what they were singing. So they were very true. It wasn't dishonest. They were singing just them, and they made their personalities and they put it into the music, and it was all just so catchy and wonderful. You know, sometimes you hear something for the first time and you just know, you're like, yep, that's it. And since then, you know, I've been inspired. I love a lot of bands from the 80s. Once again, if there's any kids watching, you know, ask your parents maybe. Tears for Fears. Do a lot of shout, let it all out. Hall & Oates, whoa, here she comes. The Police. I also love a lot of bands now. I'm sorry, I love the Biebs, Justin Bieber. I like a lot of his music. We also share the same birthday.
Wow, that's pretty amazing to have a birthday with a celebrity. Although I suppose you're a little bit of a celebrity
yourself.
Yeah,
we have that connection together and call each other from now on.
For all the kids at home, what can they do to pursue a career in the music?
Well, for all the kids at home who are interested in pursuing a career in music or wanting to learn more about it, the main ingredients are to be curious always and to be confident. So, with curiosity comes if you're at school or if you have friends or family that are musicians, to not be afraid to ask them about their instrument or tell them, I'm interested in maybe pursuing a career in music. What can I do to start that? Or, once again, if you have any teachers or someone, just ask about it. Always be curious about learning more on the process of becoming however you want to call it, to play professionally. Just ask, how do I do it? How do I do it? And just keep asking, and you'll learn more and more. And to be confident, so to play any instrument and get any satisfaction out of it, you just got to be you and know that whatever I have is enough, and playing this musical instrument or whatever you're doing is completely you. You're honest about it, you're doing you, and you're shining. So to be confident and really believe in yourself, which is the case for anything in life that you want to achieve. Once you believe in yourself, and everyone has the potential to believe in themselves and be the full them. So confidence, curiosity, and rock.
Wow, that sounds like a good start. So is there any chance we could persuade you to play a little song for us?
Sure, Quinn, I'd love to. How's that sound, Quinn? Does that sound all right?
Well, that sounds amazing.
Okay, I trust you.
I would never lie.
I know you wouldn't. I can tell by the stash.
Yes, it's a
mark
very,
of honesty. It's a mark of honesty.
Very honest mustache.
Very honest. Okay. Okay, so the song I will sing is called Help by the Beatles. I'm going to play it because, especially in these times, or if any of you have ever felt alone and you didn't, you know, you felt like you couldn't talk to anyone or relate to anyone, you can always ask for help, no matter what. There's always someone, and don't be afraid to ask for help. And so the song, it's called Help As It Was.
It's a good life lesson.
Yes, all right. Now, it's going to be best if you nod your head, and that'll kind of help me to keep my confidence, yes, and kind of rock out. Thank you. Okay, ready?
Help, I need somebody help. Not just anybody help. You know I need someone help. When I was younger, so much younger than today, never needed anybody's help in any way. But now these days are gone, I'm not so self-assured. Know that I just need your like never done before. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate you being around. Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please help me, Quinn?
Got it.
And now my life has changed in oh so many ways. My independence seemed to vanish in the haze. But every now and then I feel so insecure. Know that I just need you like never done before. Well, help me if you can, I'm feeling down. Do appreciate you being round. Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please help me? Help me, help me. Ooh.
Woo! That is some amazing music.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much for coming here today and for showing all the kids how fun and awesome music is.
Thank you very much. Yes, and once again, anyone, you know, everyone has a, you know, a little beat, anything you do. So if you like that beat and you like to rock and you like to be you, definitely do music or anything else that helps you express you to the world, because they deserve to know each and every one of you and your shine.
You have an amazing idea right there. Everyone, just remember to enjoy yourself, have fun, and don't forget to express yourself, whether it be through music or any of the other arts. Have a great day, everyone, and thank you again.
Hi, Eugene. What's going on?
No, not much. Just plucking the old guitar here. You know, Beatrice, there's nothing better than sitting on the porch in the dusk of a cold evening with a glass of warm lemonade, strumming the old six string. Would you like to hear a tune?
Would I ever? Gotta say, Eugene, for all the years I've known you, I never knew that you were a singer-songwriter.
Well, I am. Now, before I play my little ditty just for you, I just wanted to let you know that I've been practicing this song for weeks, you see, and I'm trying to break a world record.
Break a world record? Oh, I see. Like the longest song recorded or something. Oh, that song was The Rise and Fall of Bossa Nova by PC3. The song lasted 13 hours, 23 minutes, and 32 seconds.
Well, not exactly the longest song. I was thinking more about the...
But you know, that's just the longest song recorded.
What?
There's certainly a longer song.
Wow.
Did you know that the piece of music being performed by the city of Hadelsburstadt in Germany is much longer than 13 hours? In fact,
wow.
A composition by John Cage for organ 2, ASLAP, or As Slow As Possible, is recording in an extreme interpretation that will take 639 years.
What?
That means it will be completed in the year 2640. Now that's a long song.
It sure is, Beatrice. But I'm not shooting for the longest song. Oh, no. I'm going for the shortest song in history.
The shortest?
Yeah, the shortest.
In history.
That's right, Beatrice. In history. Okay, here it goes. Burgers, hold the onion.
Is that the song?
Yeah, that's the song.
Just like burgers, hold the onions.
Burgers, hold the onions.
You could pick only one lyric in all the words in all the world, and you chose to start with burger.
That's right, Beatrice.
Not too bad, actually. It's got kind of a little ring to it.
Yes.
Hey, guys. Just making sure you guys remember to fill out your time logs. Remember, you can bring your time log in at any time to get those reading hours turned into tickets. Those tickets can be used to be entered in for all kinds of prize drawings that'll be drawn at the end of the summer reading program. Also, as you fill out your time log, you can win Insta prizes. Prizes you will instantly get for reading certain levels up to certain levels on your time log. So remember, keep coming in, keep bringing in your time log, because you can win all sorts of fun stuff. Everyone, take care and keep reading.
And now my life has changed in oh so many ways. My independence seemed to vanish in the haze. But every